Hi friends, today we are going to study real numbers and we have started this chapter with an introduction video and today we are going to discuss exercise 1.1 from it. So we are going to learn about Euclid's division lemma. We have already learned the introduction in the previous video, but now we are going to see the equation of it. So according to Euclid's division lemma, if we have two positive integers that are a and b, then there exist unique integers q and r. So how they exist, let us see that. It satisfies the equation a equals to bq plus r. If a and b are present, then we have q and r also. So how r is interrelated with b? So r is greater than or equal to 0 and it is less than b. Okay. So exercise 1.1, first bit, first question, that is use Euclid's algorithm to find HCF of 900 and 270. So we have learned that Euclid's algorithm is a equals to bq plus r. So we have got a and b. A equals to 900, b equals to 270. So now we have to find q and r. So let us substitute that in this equation. Let's draw a box for it. So 900 equals to 270 into q plus r. So we'll take this 270 to LHS. So we divide it by 900. So what we get is, let us take a rough column here. 900 gets divided by 270. 273 we get 0, that is 810, so we get 90 here. Okay, 900 minus 810 we get 90. So how we can write it? 900 equals to 270, we have quotient 3 here into 3 plus remainder of 90, that is 90. So next what we take is 270. So 270 gets divided by 90. So 270 gets divided by 90. 93 is a 270. 270 minus 270 is 0. So 90 into 3 plus 0. So we have got the 0 as the remainder. Then this is the HCF. So HCF of 900 and 270 is 90. So second question is, use division algorithm to show that any positive odd integer is of the form 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5. So we have to find, let a be the positive integer. Let a be the positive integer. So what we have here, b, let us take b equals to 6, because we have 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3, it is of the form bq plus r. It is of the form bq plus r. A equals to bq plus r. It is of the form a equals to bq plus r. So what we have b as common, that is 6. So let us take b equals to 6. Okay. Now what we get the remainders as? Remainders we get 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and not 6. Only till 5. Because remainder equals to less than b. Remainder is less than b. So all the values including 0 and less than b. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the values less than 6. So how we can write the equation? A equals to 6q plus 0. A equals to 6q plus 1. A equals to 6q plus 2. A equals to 6q plus 3. A equals to 6q plus 4. A equals to 6q plus 5. Okay. So now this equals to 6 cube, this is equals to 6 cube plus 1, this equals to 6 cube plus 2, this equals to 6 cube plus 3, this equals to 6 cube plus 4, this equals to 6 cube plus 5. So now what we have to do is, we have to take the common. Common means, so we can write 6 as 2 into 3 cube. Okay, so we can write here 2 into 3 cube plus 1, and here we can write 2 into 3 cube plus 2. So here 2 into 3 cube plus 3, and here we get 2 into 3 cube plus 4. Here we can write as 2 into 3 cube plus 5, right? So now we have to see that odd, where odd integers are coming, that is here, here and here. We are getting only in three options, that as 6 cube plus 1, 6 cube plus 3 and 6 cube plus 5. So in the question he has asked that to show that we have 6 cube plus 1, 6 cube plus 3 and 6 cube plus 5, where any positive odd integer is of this form. So we can write that we can say that any positive integer is of the form 6 cube plus 1, 6 cube plus 3 or 6 cube plus 5. And here you can see that this is even, this is odd. This is even, this is odd, this is even, and this is odd. Okay? So third question is, use division algorithm to show that the square of any positive integer is of the form 3p or 3p plus 1. So let us take, in every question we have to do that. First is, let us take positive integer as a. Okay, a will be our positive integer, so a equals to b cube plus r from Euclid's division lemma, right? Euclid's division lemma. So now we have got 3p or 3p plus 1. So we can take b equals to 3. Because this is of the form a equals to bq plus r. This is of the form a equals to bq plus r. And b is common in this, that is 3. How? Let us see that. 3p is given. We can write 3p as a equals to 3p plus 0. It is of the form a equals to bq plus r, right? 3p plus 1 is given. We can write a equals to bq plus r. So b equals to 3, q is p and r is 1. Okay. In this way we can write this 2. So now in the problem we can write, we have 3 as b. What is r? R will be, what is the condition for r? R is 0 less than 0 equal to or greater than r and less than b, right? R is equal to or greater than 0 and it is less than b. So what we have b here? 3. So 0 less than r, then 3. So what the numbers we have between 0 and 3? That are r equals to 0, 1, 2. So we have 3 choices here. So we can write that a equals to 3 cube plus 0. A equals to 3 cube plus 1. A equals to 3 cube plus 2. Right? These are the 3 choices we have. So we have asked that to show that the square of any positive integer. So we should take square of these 3. So first let us mark these equations as 1, 2, 3. So from first equation, a equals to 3 cube. From equation 1, a equals to 3 cube. We will square it. A square equals to 3 cube whole square. What it will be? 9 क्यू स्क्वायर, ए स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू 9 क्यू स्क्वायर. सो वी विल टेक 3 एज कॉमन. सो 3 एज कॉमन, व्हाट वी गेट हियर, 3 क्यू स्क्वायर. सो नाउ वी विल कंसिडर 3 क्यू स्क्वायर एज पी. सो इफ वी कंसिडर 3 क्यू स्क्वायर एज पी, वी गेट 3 पी. ओके, वी गेट ए स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू 3 पी. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट सोल्यूशन वी गेट हियर. सो वी हैव कंसिडर 3 क्यू स्क्वायर एज पी. फ्रॉम इक्वेशन 2, व्हाट वी गॉट इक्वेशन 2, दैट इज ए इक्वल्स टू 3 क्यू प्लस 1. सो वी स्क्वायर इट, ए स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू 3 क्यू प्लस 1 होल स्क्वायर. That will be 9 q square plus 1 plus 6 q. A plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab. So a square equals to 9 q square plus 6 q plus 1. So we will take 3 as common between these two. So 3 as common, 3 q square plus 2 q plus 1. So we will consider 3 q square plus 2 q as p. So it will become 3 p plus 1. 3 q square plus 2 q implies 2 p here. Right? So we have got the second one, that is a square equals to 3 p plus 1. So if you want to prove third equation also, we will take that. From equation 3, we get a equals to 3 q plus 2. So a square equals to 3 q plus 2 whole square. So that will be 9 q square plus 4 plus 12 q. So there will be only changing values, but you will get a square equals to 3 p plus 1 in the last. Let us see that also. That will be 9 q square plus 12 q plus 4. Right? So we will take 3 as common here. So before taking 3 as common, we have to write 9 q square plus 12 q plus 3 and plus 1 as common, because in 4 we can't take 3 as common. So we have to write separately 3 and 1. So a square equals to 9 q square plus 12 q plus 3 plus 1. So we take 3 common here. What we get? 3 q square plus 4 q plus 1 and plus 1. So we will consider 3 q square plus 4 q plus 1 as p. So what we get? 3 p plus 1. A square equals to 3 p plus 1. So from these 3 boxes, we can say that square of any positive, we have to write full form of positive, of the form 3p or 3p plus 1, 3p or 3p plus 1. So this is the solution for the question number 3. So question number 4 of exercise 1.1. Use division algorithm to show that the cube of any positive integer is of the form 9m, 9m plus 1 and 9m plus 8. So we have to use division algorithm to show that cube of any positive integer, cube of any number positive integer is of these three forms only. So let us take a as positive integer, right? So we have seen a equals to b q plus r, where r is equal to or greater than 0 and less than b. So if we see these three forms, we get that b equals to 9. So now we will write the equations of a equals to 9 q plus r. What will be the possibilities of r? R could be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 8, because remainder should be less than b, and it can be equal to or greater than 0. So we get the equations like this: 9 cube plus 0, a equals to 9 cube plus 1, a equals to 9 cube plus 2, up to a equals to 9 cube plus 8. A equals to 9 cube plus 8. So we have taken this all equations. Now we will solve a equals to 9 cube plus 0. So a equals to 9 cube. 0 we can't take anything, we can write or not. So what we have given? Cube of any positive integer. So we write a cube equals to 9 cube whole cube. So 9 cube will be, that is 729 cube cube. A cube equals to 729 cube cube. So that we can write as, we can take 9 as common, because we have to prove that it is as 9m. So we will take 9 as common and we will get 81 cube cube. A cube equals to 9 as common, we will get 81 cube cube. So what we can write this 81 cube cube as? We will consider 81 cube cube equals to m. So what we get? A cube equals to 9m. So draw this a box and we get the first form of the equation. Label it as 1. So what we got? The second equation, a equals to 9 cube plus 1. Right? You got the second equation, a equals to 9 cube plus 1. So we'll cube it. A cube equals to 9 cube plus 1 whole cube. So a plus b whole cube. A plus b whole cube equals to a plus b whole cube equals to a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square. So we have another formula also, that is a plus b whole square into a plus b. So we can do this also, right? So we will use the second formula only. A cube equals to 9 cube plus 1 whole square into 9 cube plus 1. So what we get? 81 q square plus 1 plus 18 q into 9 q plus 1. So 9 q into 81 q square will be 729 q cube. 9 cube into 1 will be 9 q plus 9 q. 9 q into 18 will be 18 9 ja 162 q. So again we will multiply this equation by 1. We will get 81 q square plus 1 plus 18 cube. So we have got 729 cube cube plus 9 cube plus 162 cube plus 81 cube square plus 1 plus 18 cube. So we have that one cube term as only one. So we will write as 729 cube cube. And we have square term also one. We will write 81 cube square. Then we have to add the cube terms. What we got? 9 cube plus 162 q, it will be 171 q plus 18 q, 171 189 q, right? And we have 1. So we will take 9 as common from here. What we get? 81 q cube plus 9 q square plus 21 q and 1 as outside. So we'll consider 81 q cube plus 9 q square plus 21 q as m. So what we get? 9 m plus 1. A cube equals to 9 m plus 1. So this is the second form which we have to prove. So next we have got equation 9 q plus 2. A cube equals to 9 a equals to 9 cube plus 2. So we'll cube it on both sides. A cube equals to 9 cube plus 2 whole cube. So what we get? 9 cube plus 2 whole square into 9 cube plus 2. What will be the value? 9q plus 2 whole square will be 81q square, 2 square will be 4, plus 2ab means 9 into 2, 18, 18 to the 36q. And this we will be multiplying with 9q plus 2. So 9q into 81q square will be 729q cube. 9q into 4 will be 36q. 9q into 36 will be 9, we'll do that 36 into 9. 9, 6 is 54. 9, 3 is 27, 324. Plus 324 q square. So again we will multiply with 2. 81 into 2, 162 q square. 2 into 4 will be 8. And 2 into 36 will be 72 q. So you have got the term 8, and we have also 8 in the question also. So 729 q cube, and square terms on one side 162 and 324. What it will be? 26, 380, 86 q square plus 36 q plus 72 q. It will be 108 q plus 8. So we will take 9 as common. We will get 81 q cube plus 9, 5 is 45, 3, 9, 4 is 36, 54 q square plus 9, 12 is 108 plus 8. So we will consider 81 q cube plus 54 q plus 12 q as m. So we will get 9m plus 8. A cube equals to 9m plus 8. So therefore we can say that cube of any positive integer is in the form of 9m, 9m plus 1 and 9m plus 8. So this is a solution to the question number 4. So copy down all these solutions to the question of the exercise 1.1 and note down these notes, and if you have any doubts, please let me know in the comments and subscribe the channel. Thank you.